I'm very apolitical, which means that I'm here representing the State Department because I feel they're unbalanced. Now, here in one of our State Department publications here, this is the San Francisco Examiner, have a long letter from Eugene Burdick, and it describes this ideological circus, and his implication is that politics and the circus shouldn't be mixed. And I kept thinking he was talking about the Democratic National Convention. And then he says, there will be comedians, folk singers, ministers, serious commentators, and silly commentators. Now, I'm one of your silly commentators, and I thought I'd have a little audience participation here because he leaves something out. He said, there will be thrills of horror, gasps of partisan shock, laughter, and the low bellow of the true believer. Now, if you'd join in with me in a few of these, I'll read them off, okay? Let's have first some thrills of horror. Let's hear it out there now. That's all right. All right, now let's have a gasp of partisan shock. That's good, that's good. Very good. All right. Now, let's see if you can come up with some extremist laughter. That's good. That's good. All right. Now, this one is the real challenge. I want the low bellow of the true believer. Okay. Very good. Don't do that. You realize that now the call bulletin will say you're leftist because you applaud for yourselves the way Khrushchev did? Every subtle gesture counts. Now, thing about Burdick, by the way, is, oh, there's a new book of his for sale, by the way, at the literature table out there. It's called I Was a Teach-In Dropout. Now, I have here a comic book, which I'd like to talk about briefly. This is Jungle War Stories. It's the only comic book on the market that deals with the war in Vietnam. Every single other one deals with World War II, because it's much easier to tell the good guys from the bad guys in retrospect. Now, on the cover, they say, helicopters aren't always the answer against the stinging fire of Viet Cong guerrillas. And they have the answer inside. Now, first of all, before that, they have these Viet Cong guerrillas who kidnap a bunch of school children. They get spotted by the Vietnamese because they've raided the village before, and so the Viet Cong open fire. Now, there are several ways you can tell, subtle ways, that you can tell the difference between the good guys and the bad guys in the war on Vietnam. One of the ways is by what they say when they die. The Vietnamese say, ai. The Viet Cong go, ung. Whereas the American military advisors go, arg. Now, you can also tell by the sounds that their weapons make. The Viet Cong weapons go, da-da-da-da-da-da-da, showing the Russian influence. The Vietnamese weapons supplied by the American military advisors go blam, blam, with exclamation points. So they open fire here. Now what happens is that one of the American military advisors, and they're all named Duke or Mike and have blonde hair, the Vietnamese general says, this is a desperate situation. Does anyone have a suggestion? One of them says, maybe I can help, General. There's a crazy idea buzzing around in my bonnet. It goes like this. And he tells them, and they get this carload of stuff shipped, and they come down, and there the Viet Cong looking up, and Mike Williams here says in the helicopter, it's raining hot metal up here, time for us to spring a surprise of our own. The surprise is tear gas. Now, I did some research on this. This is the April-June issue. It went on sale in February. It went to the printer in December. The stories were written November and previous to November. We only announced using tear gas in real life on March 22nd. One begins to get a little suspicious of where the Pentagon gets its military strategy from.